You've always been here with me, and in your eyes, baby, I can see it's my reflection. Double so true, and what it tells me is that I belong to you. And when we pass each other once again, then I will recognize my true friend. And we are two friends lost in time. When your eyes are passing mine, I see we've been through so much in our lives. We are two friends so in love through time. Where did you go? And what is in your face that shows a story buried deep and strong? But that's a secret.
Dan net voordat iemand kom, net myself bekendstel en bietjie u geruststel. Ou Chris het nou net verneem of sy bruid nog daar is waar hy haar laas gelos het, so hy lyk my is bietjie gespanne. Maar dis reg so Chris, dis min dat ons hom gespanne kry. So vandag is jou beurt om gespanne te raak. My naam is Pieter van Santen. Ek is van die NG Kerk George Tynedal, die ander mooi plek naas Stellenbos. Ek is 20 jaar baie gelukkig getroud met Anlie en ek het 3 kinders. Op George, ek nou so 2 jaar daar, ek en Chris kom al 25 jaar saam, van die 12de December 1989, nou dis een ander lang story, ons het baie sakke sout saam opgeëet, ek voel eindelijk deel van die kerkfamilie. Ek wonder wie vandag die dankbaarste is, of het Chris se ma is, dat hy nou uiteindelik sy ou sienkie kan afgee, en of het sy pelle is wat dankbaar is, het Chris uiteindelik een vrou gekry het. So ons sal nou later sien as hy sy, sy tannie. O, lyk my, daar is nog ander mense wat ook dankbaar is. Na die hel wat hulle gehad het met die visums, julle het allemaal die e-posse gekry, nee, dit was ongelooflik. Ek as theoloog kan nie anders as om te sê, die Here se hand is in die dinge. Die Heer Suid-Afrikaanse, draconiese, binnenlandse sake, wette en allerhande goed deur, sit Chris hier en hy gaan trouw met die liefde van sy lewe. Daar is ons allemaal baie opgewonde. Ek wil net gauw sê, net ter wille van die Sharks, ek het 'n pastorale spreekkamer na die tyd. Is daar... Gou stommers. Ek weet nie eens wat die telling was, ek het ophou kyk so.
Vriend... Die stommers geplop het, hoor. O,
ja, ok, ja, nou word hulle gestraf, ja. Vriende, ek kan rustig sit en ontspan. Die enigste ou wat gespanne hier rond sal wees is Chris. So kom ons lag vir hom en geniet dit. En dan, jy hoef nie bekommerd te wees, ek het hier lang asem mee, ons is in 'n half uur uit en thuis. En daar is 'n kaggel waar ons gaan eet, so ek sal so gauw as moontlik maak. Ons wag net vir Ima, so geniet dit. Baie dankie. Excuse toch, as enige van die cellfone het, wil jy dit net op silent of op pilot mode of wat, flight mode of so sit nie, dat het ons net die plaat terwyl ons besig is. Baie dankie. Dit lyk of Ima die voor nou gestop het, of Chris begin al op leker raak. ek wil net gauw vir u sê, ek sit met een probleem wat ek net of u gesê het. My bruidegom is uitstekend in Engels. My bruid verstaan so bietjie Engels en my oupa se van was potgieter. So u moet my Engels verskoon. Ek gaan my heel beste probeer, maar as ek gaan bid, of as ek gaan grappies vertel, of passievol gaan raak, sal ek oorslaan Afrikaans. Baie dankie hoor. Kan ons maar die deure agter toe maak asseblief, dis daarom bietjie koud hier binne. Ima, you look wow. Chris, jy moet eintlik na my kyk as ek praat, hoor, nie. Thank you for the privilege to share this amazing day with you. When I was preparing my sermon, I was thinking this day fills everybody here with wonder. Wonder in the sense that God is putting two people together today. And wonder that Chris is actually and eventually finding his match. I mean, everybody is in wonder about that. We are gathered here before God and his people to be reminded of promises that we've made in our lives. So, in a sense, everybody that is here that is married, you can sit a little bit closer to your partner and listen to what God wants us to know about his love and about putting two people together. I'm wearing a liturgische band, and on it is the scarf.
Liturgic scarf.
Liturgic scarf. Okay. Ek leer Engels vandag. And on it is the first and the last letter of the Greek alphabet. God is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. God is the beginning and the end of you two. He started you, and he'll be the end of that as well. So, thank you for that. And I would like the witnesses here to see what I see. So, LZ, I'm sorry. She must turn around that everybody can see how beautiful she is, and they can take photos. And Chris, you look nice as well. I've never seen you like this. You normally you have a pluckies in a khaki brook, but today you look good. So you can turn around and the people can take photos and let's give them a hand. They really look beautiful. That's not any key. I say. Now can you let me weer terugdraai? You can turn back. Whilst I was preparing, Ima, I realized that for Chris to look like this, you already have a very positive influence on him. So thank you for that. His mother is especially glad about that. While I was preparing, I came across two jokes which I think is very applicable in this scenario. So I just want to read it to you. Attending a wedding for the first time, a little girl whispered to her mother, "Mom, why is the bride dressed in white?" The mother replied, "Because white is the color of happiness, and today is the happiest day of her life." The child thought about this for a moment, then said, "So why is the groom wearing black?" In Chris' geval is dit nou nie so en ek weet dit is die mooiste en die beste dag van sy lewe. Die tweede enetjie vertel hulle van Chris wat in die sonnaskool sit. Nou terwyl van Ina sal ek hom nou in Engels ook vertel. At a Sunday school, they were teaching how God created everything, including human beings. Little Chris seemed especially intent when they told him how Eve was created out of Adam's ribs. Chris is 'n opgeleide zooloog, so ek verstaan nou waar dit vandaan kom. Later in the week, his mother noticed him lying down as though he were ill, and she said, "Chris, what's the matter?" Little Chris responded, "I have a pain in my side. I think I'm going to have a wife." Ima, luckily, Chris didn't get you like that. So. I prefer to do the official stuff first, so we're going to do the whole thing now. So I'm going to start with the huweliksformulier, the solemnization of the marriage. So, Ima and Chris, we've come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of you two today. We have also come together to ask his blessing on them and to rejoice with them. Our Lord Jesus Christ, by his presence at the marriage in Cana in Galilee, blessed this life commitment between two people. Now you must listen. Marriage is an expression of God's loving care when in the beginning he said, "It's not good for the man to live alone. I will make a suitable companion to help him." You are more than suitable for Chris, Ima. So he created them as partners for one another to supplement and help one another. To be thus united in the Lord is a privilege, a joy, and a huge responsibility. Elsewhere in the Bible, marriage is likened to the relationship between Christ and his church. As Christ and the church are a union, so too you are a union of husband and wife. As Christ is united with his church, so too you are united with a bond of love. As Christ loved the church, so too you must love one another. And as Christ gave his life for the church, so too you should give yourself in love to one another. And as the church is loyal to Christ, so too you should be loyal to one another and serve one another's interests. I'm going to ask them a few questions, and the witnesses must please listen very carefully to their answers. Ima and Chris, do you accept everything the Lord teaches us in his word concerning the Christian marriage and state of matrimony? Is it your firm intention to arrange your marital life accordingly? And do you wish for the blessing in God in the solemnization of your marriage? What is your answer?
Yes.
Now that they can.